Do you remember the concepts we studied in the previous lesson? First, we understood that opaque objects do not allow light to pass through them. Second, transparent objects allow light to pass through them and we can see through them clearly. And third, translucent objects allow light to pass through them partially. Now I want you to answer this question. What kind of an object is a human body? Are we able to see through it? Not really. Hence, a human body is an opaque object. What happens when light is obstructed by the human body? We see that the human body is obstructing light here. There is light in front of the human body, but what do you see behind it? Yes, a shadow. This thing you see behind the body is called a shadow. Now, looking at this, can you tell me the things that are required for a shadow to be formed? Two things are obvious. First, a source of light, which is in front of the body. And second, an opaque object. Here, the human body is the opaque object. Can you identify any other thing we may need for a shadow? Maybe not. Now let's consider a different situation. In this situation too, we have a source of light as well as an opaque body. But do we see a shadow? No, we don't. Do you know why? Perplexed? Well, had there been a screen behind the opaque object, you would have seen the shadow on it. But because there is no screen or surface like in the previous case, we cannot see the shadow. What does this tell us? It tells us that we also need a surface on which a shadow can be formed. That surface will make us see the shadow. What's so special about shadows? Shadows also give us some information about the object. So if I show you this shadow, you will be able to tell me that it's a human body's shadow. But sometimes they can also be misleading. For instance, can you name the body of which this is a shadow? You'd probably say it's that of a dog, but it's just our human hands playing the trick. Has it ever occurred to you as to why shadows are formed? We know one of the reasons. Opaque bodies do not allow light to pass through them. Yes, that's one of the main reasons why shadows are formed. Another important reason for shadows to form is that light travels in a straight line. We will see its use in our next lesson.